So you just had a conversation yesterday, if I understand, with a group of doctors, talking with them about how evolutionary thinking would improve medical practice.
Yes. I was talking to some residents from the University of New Mexico. So they're all quite young and quite open to new ideas. And because they were taught occasionally by my host there, Joe Alcock, they had begun to hear a little bit about evolutionary medicine.
So certainly they learned evolution before, or did they?
No, I don't think so. I think what little they knew, they had picked up from a few classes that Joe gives there.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so a very smattering, but intrigued, I think.
So what kind of things did they say they found useful?
Well, they didn't. You don't get clear, helpful feedback like that from audiences of students, postgrad or undergrad. Mm-hmm. You just sort of look at them and try and figure out, are they somehow interesting and captured by what you're doing, or are they busy on their iPhones? But mm-hmm. So you don't really get the feedback, except. Mm-hmm. I did try to suggest a few ways in which, if this evolutionary medicine thinking does come to the fore and is accepted and taken on board by more people in the medical profession, how might it change medical practice, the delivery of medicine?
So which one grabbed them the most? Which one seemed the most relevant to them?
I would think possibly when I was talking about the hygiene hypothesis,
uh-huh.
Which, as you know, is now more properly called the old friends hypothesis, mm-hmm. and trying to explain to them that the reason it's called the old friends hypothesis is not because we're introduced to these friendly bacteria in the environment after birth, but because for millions upon millions of years, we have cohabited with these microorganisms, and they have actually populated our guts and our other mucosal cells.
So the old friends hypothesis is that, in fact, we evolved with these organisms and we need them? Is that the general idea?
We evolved with these organisms. We, in a sense, co-evolved. Something which goes beyond commensalism and beyond sort of mutual dependency in many ways. Our association with them is so intimate that a lot of researchers who study this almost talk about a superorganism.
And if one of them goes missing, or a bunch of them go missing because of antibiotics or something else, then what happens?
Well, if they go missing, as you say, because, I mean, it's this classic case of what's known in evolutionary medicine circles as mismatch, which is that in this particular case, our immune systems evolved over millions of years in the context and presence of these microorganisms, long-term partners with us in our guts. And so what has happened is that the bacteria, for instance, actually have taken over the control or regulation of our immune systems. The genes for the control of our immune systems reside in the bugs inside us and not in us.
So do they make their immune system more active or less active or what?
Well, no, they tend to make it less active because it suits them. They want to have an immune system that doesn't attack them, otherwise they couldn't live inside us.
Uh-huh.
And we need to tolerate them because until the advent of modern drugs and things like that, of course, we couldn't get rid of them.
So do bugs in our gut do good things for us other than regulating our immune system?
Well, I think they do a whole range of good things for us. But, I mean, just if you think about regulating our immune systems, that's going to actually improve our resistance enormously to a whole range of atopic illnesses like allergy and asthma and rhinitis and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
And it's also going to improve our resistance to getting a whole range of what we call autoimmune diseases.
So what is an autoimmune disease?
Well, an autoimmune disease, very sort of colloquially, is when the immune system in our bodies turns on us.
And what are some examples?
Rheumatoid arthritis, type 1 diabetes, multiple sclerosis is another good example. And even autism has been cast now as an autoimmune disease. It's been shown to have very strong autoimmune components to it.